Hello and welcome to my channel, Hardware AI. Today we are going to be talking about two new products recently appearing on the market, Coral Dev Board from Google and Jetson Nano from Nvidia. I already made two videos about Coral Board, showcasing the hardware and transfer learning demo. Many people asked me to make a comparison of these two boards, since despite Jetson Nano and Coral Dev Board being vastly different, essentially they're occupying the same niche of hardware for deep learning inference acceleration. For those who prefer the shortened version, here is a short version. I hope there is not too many technical details here. Round 1. Fight!
Finish her!
All right. Well, that's the gist of it, basically. And if you really want to listen to a short version, a sound bite from it, you can just click on the card and see the last part of the video. Now, for those who would like to learn more and in details about the comparison, let's start with comparing the hardware specs. Coral Dev Board has a quad-core Cortex A53 CPU, which is basically the same as Raspberry Pi, same microarchitecture as Raspberry Pi. Plus, it has a low-power CPU, Cortex M4F. Nvidia Jetson Nano has slightly stronger CPU with Cortex A57 microarchitecture. For the RAM, Nvidia Jetson Nano is a clear leader. It has 4 GB, low power DDR4, whereas Google Dev Board just has 1 GB, which is probably why they don't recommend you to use desktop environment. eMMC flash, Nvidia Jetson Nano also has more of it. This is 16 GB versus 8 for Google Dev Board. And then for GPU, Jetson Nano has Nvidia Maxwell architecture GPU with 128 Nvidia CUDA cores, and Google Coral Dev Board has integrated Vivante mobile graphics. But of course, those two boards, most of the people will not use them as regular desktops. They want to use them for machine learning inference. And machine learning inference accelerator in Google Dev Board, it's an Isaac, it's a proprietary Google's Edge TPU. And for the Nvidia Jetson Nano, it uses its GPU with 128 CUDA cores to accelerate deep learning algorithms. Wireless connection wise, Jetson Nano has none. You need to buy a separate wireless adapter. And Google Coral Dev Board has onboard Wi-Fi, both 2.4 and 5 GHz, and also Bluetooth 4.2, Bluetooth Low Energy. Now, finally, the price. Google Coral Dev Board is priced slightly higher at $149, and Nvidia Jetson Nano is cheaper for $99. So, just a quick summary. As we can see, Nvidia Jetson Nano overall has better specs. It has a better CPU, it has more memory, and obviously it has a better GPU. If you wanted to make a desktop computer out of it and, I don't know, browse, type documents, play some games, then Nvidia Jetson Nano would be a clear winner. But this is not how most of the people are going to use them. Next, we're going to have a look at the performance results comparison. Here is another table, official benchmarking results from Nvidia and Google. First one is benchmark on Inception version 4, which is a convolutional neural network used for image recognition. Nvidia Jetson Nano manages to have 11 frames per second, and Google Coral Dev Board is around the same, 9 to 10 frames per second. Unfortunately, it's very difficult to make a comparison according to official benchmarking results because they're using different neural networks for benchmarks and also different input layer sizes, which also affects the performance.
When looking at the numbers, pay attention to the fine print though. All of the benchmarks are performed using C++ benchmark tests. Also, Google's numbers are for the inference stage on its own. That's much cleaner and short operation. The steps before that are executed on CPU, which is quite weak on Google Dev Board. It's an older Cortex-A53. Because the official benchmarks are inconclusive, I decided to make some of my own tests. Here are the results of my own benchmarks for MobileNet SSD version 2. It's an object detection network trained on COCA dataset, 300x300 input resolution in TensorFlow. For inference on Jetson Nano, model was optimized and executed with TFTRT, which is TensorFlow TensorRT. And Google board was using TensorFlow Lite and pre-trained model provided by Google. As we see, Nvidia Jetson Nano manages the speed of 72 milliseconds per inference, and Google Coral Dev Board has much faster speed, almost more than three times faster, at 20.7 milliseconds per inference. Finally, let's compare the user experience for those boards in question. First of all, let's talk about the operating system on the boards. Nvidia Jetson Nano has a derivative of Ubuntu 18.04, and it feels much like regular Ubuntu desktop. Google Coral Dev Board has a Mendel OS derivative of Debian Stretch. There is no desktop environment pre-configured, although you can obviously install your favorite desktop environment yourself, but from the box there is nothing configured. For the deep learning frameworks, on Google Dev Board you can only use TensorFlow Lite, and for Jetson Nano you can use any deep learning network of your choice: TensorFlow, PyTorch, Cafe, Keras, or MXNet. Both boards support on-device training. In case of Nvidia Jetson Nano, it's just regular training with backpropagation, so it's a bit slow, but it's a regular training pipeline, as you would do in case with your desktop computer with GPU. Google Coral Dev Board also supports on-device training with no backpropagation, using clever technique called low-shot learning, which uses pre-trained feature extractor to embed the object's features into the last layer of the neural network. You can run any model you can run with your regular desktop GPU on Nvidia Jetson Nano, but for better results, you want to do some model optimizations using TensorRT. For Google Coral Dev Board, the model optimization is necessary. You can do it both using the cloud model compiler or on the device. And model needs to be trained using quantization-aware training. Let me explain this part to you. Basically, you cannot just take any random model that you found on the internet or trained yourself before that. The model needs to be trained using quantization-aware training. And for example, when I was looking for ResNet 50 pre-trained model, I couldn't find any of them which were trained using quantization-aware training.
My personal opinion is that Nvidia Jetson Nano, despite the lack of wireless connectivity, is a better choice for hobbyists, makers, people in education, and also small-scale companies like startups. Even if you don't have a good machine learning expertise, you can just easily install your favorite deep learning network and run native inference on the board. If you optimize your model for floating point 16 or integer 8 precision, you will get better results. But it's not necessary to run the model. Coral board, in theory, provides much faster inference time and better power efficiency, but I found that it's much trickier to handle. So it is a better choice for medium to large enterprises working on edge AI and skilled machine learning engineers, or people who like the challenge indeed.
Google's Coral USB accelerator can be much better choice for hobbyists and makers,
providing machine learning inference acceleration for your favorite and familiar platform, for example, Raspberry Pi. Raspberry Pi 4 would be the best choice since it has USB 3.0 ports, which greatly reduce the bottleneck between Raspberry Pi and USB accelerator. In fact, my new video is going to be about a drone that utilizes a combination of Raspberry Pi, CC3D flight controller, and Google Coral USB accelerator for intelligent object following. Stay tuned for the new videos, and I'll see you next time!